spectacular weekend of basketball here in Salt Lake City for the Basketball Tournament 2019, and we have one more grand finale for this regional as the last two runners-up in CBT, Everline Drive and Team Challenge ALS, go head-to-head for a spot in Chicago and a shot at the $2 million. Alongside former NCAA head coach Richie Schuler, I'm Sam Farber. It is a pleasure and a privilege to have you with us here tonight. Richie, we do have the top two seeds going head-to-head here in this regional final, but it sure didn't look like it throughout. We've had a closely contested game after closely contested game, and yet the cream has risen to the top.
That's why this region is so good. Six games so far, three have gone to a next point win scenario. Not next bucket wins, next point wins. That's all because of the Elam ending.
Let's take a look at our regional bracket. You can see how close all of these games were. Everline Drive was not in just one, but two next point win situations. Challenge ALS had a similar situation last night with the hometown favorites Team Fredette, but both advanced and set up a rematch from last year's tournament, which was another hotly contested game between these two sides.
And what a great game it was. Team Challenge ALS was a year removed from being a TBT runner-up, but Everline Drive had something to say about that. Jerome Randall here in the quarterfinals with a nice dish. On the other side, it was Marbell Harris really got things going for Team Challenge ALS. He was making some plays early on, but Everline Drive decided they're going to be the TBT runner-ups in this year, and it became all about them in Jerome Randall, who dropped 29 points in this game. He did it with jump shots. He did it with and-one jump shots. He got to the cup as he usually does. Jerome Randall was incredible in this game just a year ago, and here, let's see what they can do playing head-to-head in this year as well.
And Randall right there had the game winner last year. He's had both game winners for Everline Drive. In fact, last contest, he scored every one of Everline Drive's points during the Elam ending. That's why we're calling him the closer, and he will be one of the starters for Everline Drive. Our starting lineup's presented by Air Force Reserve. Explore your opportunities with the Air Force Reserve. Randall joined by Sloan in the backcourt. They have added Orlando Johnson, a guy with some NBA time, to their starting lineup.
He was terrific. One of the best scorers of all time when he was at UC Santa Barbara. He was an All-American over there, but then spent 2 years with the Pacers, a year with the San Antonio Spurs, played for four NBA teams, and wow, what an addition he's been for Everline Drive.
Plenty of NBA experience on the other side for Team Challenge ALS as well. You've got Austin Day, most prevalent among them. He spent six seasons in the association, including winning a championship with the 2014 San Antonio Spurs. Along with him, D-Boss, Marcus Haynes, DJ Strawberry, and Deshaun Stevens. Let's go through the rules of the basketball tournament in 2019. You've got 4 9-minute quarters. Each side has six fouls per player. On your sixth, you're DQ'd out of the game. In each quarter, the fifth foul puts you in the bonus. All non-shooting fouls are immediately two free throws. That has been significant throughout this tournament. Goaltending, we use the international rules, Richie.
Yeah, the FIBA rules, one of my favorite rules of TBT. Once that ball touches the rim, offensively you can punch it in, or defensively you can knock it off. It's had a lot of excitement here at the TBT.
Timeouts, you've got four to play with, including one use it or lose it that has to be taken in the first half. And finally, everyone's favorite part of the basketball tournament, the Elam ending. First dead ball under 4 minutes, turn off the clock, add eight to the leading team score. That's your target number. Man, have we had exciting finishes here in Salt Lake City, and we expect another one coming up here tonight for a shot at Chicago. Team Challenge ALS wearing the dark blues, Everline Drive in the whites. Challenge ALS, you'll notice the names on the back of the uniforms don't match the players wearing them. It instead matches someone who's been battling ALS and signifies these players, kind of putting them on their backs and fighting for them in this great cause that Sean Marshall really championed when he started this team. Talk more about that as we get into the game. We're ready to tip things off. The tip is won by Kenny Kaji of Everline Drive.
I like the way Everline Drive plays. And one reason that is because they can play with a big lineup or they can play a small lineup, and they're successful at both. You'll see them mix up throughout the course of the game.
Kaji hits the corner three. Good start for Everline Drive.
Big man at 6'11", played at Miami. He's got that deep range.
Shoot 50% from three on the tournament. So early start for Everline Drive. Again, they were in a next point wins situation in each of their first two games. Now we've got a foul call. Instead of the out of bounds, there's going to be a foul on Jerome Randall for a hold. It's going to stay Team Challenge ALS basketball.
Now, remember, the TBT rules. They play it where you never shoot a one-on-one. So per quarter, once a team gets that fifth foul, the other team gets two free throws off the bat. So you don't want to foul too early, like we just saw Eberline Drive do.
Team Challenge ALS. They trailed double figures against Utah Stallions in round one, but ended up winning by six. And thus, that feels like the blowout of the region so far, Richie.
That's crazy. These games have been outstanding. This has to be one of the best regions, best regionals we've ever seen in TBT in 6 years' history.
Wave off the attempt. It's a walk on Orlando Johnson. Going back the other way. And a little chippiness already here. Jerome Randall and DeBost been chest-to-chest a couple of possessions now.
This is a rivalry, Sam. This is huge. Here are the last two TBT runner-up champions. You're watching them play. They played last year. Eberline Drive took over Team Challenge ALS and got into the driver's seat. These two teams, there's no love lost between them.
Minute in, and it is 2-0. They actually made that a two for Kenny Kaji previously. 2-0 to score. Eberline Drive with the lead. Challenge ALS last round took on a Jimmer Fredette-less Team Fredette. Boss puts in the deuce. All even to a piece.
Eberline Drive. Donald Sloan with the basketball. 5 years NBA experience. He's an excellent three-point shooter, but he's 1 of 15 throughout the first two games. You know there's going to be a game where he's going to get off shooting the ball well. I'm expecting big things from Sloan from behind the arc tonight.
Kick to the corner, three on the way for Braun, and off on the shot attempt. Now we've got a foul called, and Team Challenge ALS with the basketball. Head coaches for this one, and with Eberline Drive, that is David Nurse. If the last name's familiar to you, it's because he is the nephew of Toronto Raptors head coach Nick Nurse, so already some championship experience.
I think maybe it rubbed off.
He was telling you how he got to hang out in the locker room after Toronto won at Golden State.
He sure did. That'd have been a fun experience. Him and his wife both.
DJ Strawberry. A little short on the runner. Strawberry, another guy who got to hang out in some cool locker rooms. He's the son of 8-time Major League Baseball All-Star and 4-time World Series champ Daryl Strawberry. Got a lid on both rims right now. They're stuck on two. Eberline Drive and Team Challenge ALS still early. Marquez Haynes misses a deep ball. Orlando Johnson not going to take any chances. Flushes it home.
Missed the layup the last possession, and he had a really good game in round one. 14 points, 8 boards, hit a 3 or 2, and then last game he struggled. He's 1 of 6 from the field, couldn't make a 3-point shot. Big for Orlando Johnson. I just think Eberline Drive, Orlando Johnson, Donald Sloan, two people who had a hard time last game in the field goal attempts as far as making them. I can just see if they get all cylinders cooking for Eberline Drive, good things can happen for them.
The look down low to Orlando Johnson. He finishes over Austin Day. In terms of styles, Richie, from what we've seen, Eberline Drive, really a guard-dominant team with that combo of Randall and Sloan. Team Challenge ALS, they've been the defensive squad in this tournament. Kaji committing the foul. It's going to send Deshaun Stevens to the line. But Team Challenge ALS, more so than anyone else, has been able to hold teams back, and it really speaks to their head coach, Darren Collison. Yes, the 10-year NBA veteran, recently retired, but he's here coaching for the second year Team Challenge ALS.
It makes you wonder, is Darren Collison going to be coaching in the near future? He's got his feet wet last year here in the TBT. Doing it again right now, coaching this team through this rematch. But so what you're saying, yeah, Team Challenge ALS does have more length. I mean, look at Deshaun Stevens on the line right now. Number 9. Out of Los Angeles, played at San Diego State. Never even played middle school or high school ball. And then you have number 5 lining up at the free throw line under the basket in Austin Day, 6-year NBA vet that you talked about. They both have length, both those guys. 6'10", 6'9", good length. Actually, Austin Day, 6'11". So that helps them protect the basket a little bit more. And it's all because they're trying to get to Chicago next week for TBT Championship Week, August 1st through 6th.
Stevens goes 1 for 2. Keith Benson, who just checked in, pulled down the rebound. 1-point lead for Eberline Drive. They're going to go right to Benson. Randall. He has most definitely been the closer in this tournament for Everline Drive. True to that, he's had terrible starts his first two games. There's a bucket for Benson.
When you talk about Jerome Randall, a player that averaged almost 22 a game in the TBT last year. In the Super 16, he was at 34 points a game. In the quarterfinals against Team Challenge ALS, he had 29.
Strawberry hits a three. That is big. DJ had shot 2 for 11 from deep through the first two games. So if he can get going early, he's not someone who's used to shooting less than 20% from anywhere. Traveling called on Braun, and we'll go back the other way. All even at 8 in this round 3 matchup, the $2 million winner take all, TBT.
It's a good pass by D. Boss. Got the defense closed in on him on the baseline. He was able to kick it out to a wide open shooter in Strawberry. At 4 of the 8. Good pass by D. Boss. Got the defense closed in on him on the baseline. He was able to kick it out to a wide open shooter in Strawberry. That 4 of the 8 teams punched their ticket to the quarterfinals. Number 5 will be right here in the next hour or so.
Boss, the TBT rookie, throwing a backdoor pass to Harris. Back it out. 12 on the shot clock, plenty of time, but he hoists an off-balance shot. Good defense from Everline Drive to get the stop. Ron, long range. The rebound to Marquez Haynes. Strawberry squares up another one. Despite making one earlier, it's still been a frustrating tournament for him shooting the ball. Ron hits this one from the baseline. Two-point advantage for Everline Drive. First quarter action. This is way deep off from Deep Bost. How about that?
I really like how he used that screen. His teammate Deshaun Stevens came up to set the screen. He didn't go completely off it and try to turn the corner. He just took a dribble off the screen, just had just enough space to get that deep three-pointer off.
Bodies hit the deck on the screen and roll play, and no call. It's just out of bounds. It's going to stay with Everline Drive. 3:15 left in the first quarter. Team Challenge ALS with a one-point lead. TBT 2019, the $2 million winner-take-all basketball tournament, is presented by Puma Basketball.
I mean, especially for me and Deshaun, you know, we're personally connected, you know what I mean? So we got a few other guys that are personally connected on this team. And when you're out there fighting and you're tired, you know, I don't know about the rest of the guys, but I think about my friend, you know what I mean? And he inspires me to play hard and to keep going even when I think that I don't have anything left, because that's exactly what he's doing, you know what I mean? So that's the mentality I have on the court. And I think the other guys have the same mentality.
Just great words from Sean Marshall talking about his college roommate Pete Frady is the originator of the Ice Bucket Challenge. He's been battling ALS, and that is the inspiration for Team Challenge ALS here in this tournament once again.
What a great cause. He's brought a lot of attention to ALS. Sean Marshall has a lot to do with that.
TBT has been a great venue for a lot of different kinds of teams. We've seen, obviously, alumni squads come out and have a lot of success and bring a lot of energy to the tournament. But I mean, how about the story from Wichita earlier today? Sideline cancer, sidelining the Wichita State alumni team, much to the dismay of the hometown crowd. But yeah, what a win there for sideline cancer. How special would it be to have sideline cancer and Team Challenge ALS go to Chicago?
Not to take away from the charitable organizations that you're talking about, but how special was that pass from Jerome Randall down to Orlando Johnson very Magic Johnson-esque with that one-handed full-court bounce pass. And Everline Drive is shooting the ball better. They're rebounding the ball better, but they have a pair of turnovers, which has kind of prevented them from extending the lead.
Good defense down at the back end. The stopper, Keith Benson, gets a block. 1 point advantage for Everline Drive. Benson, left alone, will take the three. That might have been why he was left alone. Austin Day caught a shot to the head, so the foul's going to be called on Osiris Eldridge. 2:03 left here in the first quarter. Everline Drive, a one-point advantage.
Oh, yeah. Looked like a shot to the eye. Unintentional, but I think Osiris Eldridge might have got a piece of it, but he's fine. If you look at Osiris Eldridge with his hands in the air, number two, guarding Marvell Harris, who's a phenomenal scorer for Team Challenge ALS. There's some contact there. You talk about the chippiness, the competitive nature between these two teams. Those two teams, that's a heck of a matchup right there. Eldridge, really good defender.
This isn't like the NBA where you play each other 4-plus times a year, or college where you're going to get two in conference. These guys play once a year if they make it far enough,
yeah.
And yet it's a rivalry.
Right.
Orlando Johnson fading away. That's a pro scorer right there.
He's a pro player. Four NBA teams, multiple countries overseas. In a few years in the league. Actually declared for the NBA draft after his junior year at UC Santa Barbara. He did end up returning for his senior year, but he declared and ended up coming back and had a great finish to his college career. And now he's still playing great basketball.
Seeing a little bit of Osiris Eldridge working the refs here. May have majored in politics at Illinois State. Certainly took a debate class or two. He's working hard to convince them that he didn't commit that foul. You were talking about the bonus earlier. We're in it for Team Challenge ALS. So free throws for the rest of the quarter on every foul. And Marvell Harris will take the first to try and get him going.
Marvell Harris. Great player at Fresno State, graduated about 3 years ago. He's played in the NBA Summer Leagues, played in Australia, Lebanon, Belgium.
Last year averaged 26 points per game, or last season, in the United Arab Emirates. Another professional score. There is so much talent on the floor here and across the country in every TBT regional. Turnover there, a little too aggressive by Pat Miller. Team Challenge ALS will bring it up the floor, trailing by two, coming up on 1 minute left here in the first quarter. Strawberry out to the corner. Day drives, kicks. Still looking for the best shot they can get. 15 on the shot clock. Day squaring up. Yes.
The patience with that. A lot of players get the basketball and they want to shoot it really quick. He had about three or four fakes before he put it up. The NBA vet showing how it's done.
Randall, so smooth.
Cal's all-time leading scorer, over 1,800 career points.
Think about the talent that's come through Cal for 5'10" Jerome Randall to be the all-time leading scorer. Day hits a three. But you got Jason Kidd, Jaylen Brown, Jabari Bird, Ryan Anderson.
Wow. Wow.
Jerome Randall, best scorer of them all. Shot clock is off.
Going to double team. Look at that. Trying to get the ball out of his hands. Almost worked.
Open three. Pat Miller. Too strong. Benson can't get the pass and the bucket off in time. No shot. And at the end of a quarter, we've got another tight one. Would you expect anything less, Richie?
No. It's a Salt Lake City Regional. It's outstanding.
TBT is taking over Chicago for Championship Week. Eight teams, single elimination, $2 million, winner take all. August 1st through the 6th at Wintrust Arena. Visit thetournament.com/tickets to secure your seats today.
Clearly both teams want to go, but for Jerome Randall, he definitely wants to go back home to sweet home Chicago. He is one of several Chicago, Illinois natives for Everline Drive. How special would it be to play in your hometown for $2 million?
Him and Pat Miller both. That'd be great.
Don't forget Osiris Eldridge.
should have remembered that.
Back to action. Team Challenge ALS, a one-point lead going into quarter number two. Some subs into the game. Everline driver seeing Malik Dime for the first time. He just plucked that rebound. Fourth in Washington University's record books for career blocks. The teams blinked on their first possession here in the second quarter. The last two runners-up of the basketball tournament, both of them would love a look at Overseas Elite. Kind of the only thing that's stayed the same last year to this year. I mean, the level of play has gone way, way up.
Oh, yeah.
But the only thing that's really stayed the same as Overseas Elite is the favorite. And they just don't, they don't even have close games to this point.
They're 27-0. A lot of people think they're going to go down this year. I've been one to say that as well. Just think, because the competition is so much more fierce, that there's a much higher chance they can go down. But man, aren't they special? It's a dynasty. 5 years of TBT championships. This is number six, but the first 5 years, they've won the last four.
$7 million in prize money collected. Three on the way from D-Boss. Offensive board and a foul. This is the strength of Team Challenge ALS. They are the bigger team. They have not done a great job on the glass so far today, but typically speaking, they're the three, they're the team that does better on the offensive board.
And you see Sean Marshall going up to get that basketball. Yeah, they're a good defensive team. They're a good rebounding team. They're losing that battle right now. But they have the lead, yet Everline drives hovering around 50% from the field. Haven't let Everline drive make a three yet, though. They're 0-5.
What a slip pass. Day down low to Deshaun Stevens for the slam.
6'11 to 6'8.
There's a look at tomorrow's championship matchups. I'm looking forward to seeing Overseas Elite, sorry, regional finals, I should say. Overseas Elite get things started, but then Boeheim's Army playing at home in Syracuse. Sideline Cancer, another team of the cause, going against the Marquette alumni after already dispatching two alumni teams from Kansas and Wichita State in the state of Kansas.
How about that? That's impressive. And in Wichita, they 2 days ago had the best crowd in TBT history. Over 7,000 strong filling out the arena.
Good move by Marvell Harris, his first field goal of the game. I believe this is our largest lead of the contest for either side at 5.
Expected to remain tight. These two players right there, Jerome Randall, Donald Sloan, teams have been gunning at him. Sloan has struggled to shoot from the three, still struggling to shoot from the three, but he is a superb shooter from behind the arc. But all teams know, if you can slow down Randall and Sloan, you got a chance of beating this squad, and it looks like Team Challenge ALS is following the same method.
Stevens misses the three. Talking about Sloan's three-point shooting issues here so far in Salt Lake City. We were talking to Darren Collison, head coach of Team Challenge ALS, before the game, and he said, you know, that's the kind of guy you don't want to see a one for whatever on his three-point mark for the tournament when he's coming to play you. You'd rather he was doing his average, because then maybe he'll have a bad game. He's not going to have three bad ones in a row.
He says he's going to probably break out. He's worried about the old Donald Sloan with the old playground move, inbounding it off the rear end of the defender.
Around to Randall, will fire and hit from distance. First three-pointer of the game for Everline Drive.
He's tough, man. He doesn't back down from anybody. I mean, I like, he's 5'9", 5'10", but he'll shoot there. He'll shoot a three right in your face. He is not fearful of you blocking his shot. A lot of contact. I understand why Austin Day is upset talking to the officials, because Austin Braun and him were playing pretty physical. Braun was playing pretty physical defensively on him. But you got to move forward. You got to keep your head, right? You got to keep your head.
Foul on Donald Sloan, his second. 6 minutes left in half number one. Today, physical again against Taylor Braun. This time, he does get a call.
LeBron is frustrating him. And a lot of good players will do that. They'll find ways to frustrate the player who's scoring a lot of buckets. Remember Austin Day, six-year NBA veteran. Seen him make a couple jumpers here. He's getting rebounds. Number five, Day, is a talented player. So Bron trying to get into his head a little bit, trying to rough him up just a little bit. And that sometimes can take some good players out of the game if they're mentally strong enough.
Haynes pulling up. 2 points for the Boston College / Texas Arlington alum. Played it both. Got a whistle and a foul on the other side. Substitution coming in. Kenny Kaji will replace Malik Dimes. Everline Drive wearing the whites again tonight against Team Challenge ALS and the Dark Blues. Our last two runners up. TBT. Sloan against three defenders and falls off the 10. Nice drop-off pass and the finish from DeShaun Stevens.
Team Challenge ALS team, they have weapons, right? I mean, they just seem balanced inside and out, on the wings, in the post, around the perimeter, defensively.
Sloan going up in traffic, can't hit. Another rebound. Challenge ALS, Marshall, head fake up, and he walks. He knew it.
Well, it's important for Sean Marshall there that he has a good game. One, because he's the GM of Team Challenge ALS. He's played well in the tournament so far this year. Matter of fact, he had 19 points last night to get to this third round. He struggled last year when these two teams played each other. He was 0-for-4 from the field, didn't score a basket. 2 years ago in the championship game, he was below his average. He scored 9 points. When Sean Marshall plays well, usually this team wins.
Taylor Braun, can't leave him that open. Brings it back to a one possession game. Harris, nice move.
It shows you how talented he is. He gets past his defender, and then he Euro steps past 1-2 players to the basket. The walking bucket, isn't he?
There's a few of those out there.
Yeah.
Sloan, got it.
He needed that one. He only had one in the previous two. He was 1-of-15. Sloan needs to come alive from behind the arc.
Until he took that three on this floor, he was 1-for-18 from distance. Makes it a 2-point game. It's out of bounds, and it's going to be Stan with Team Challenge ALS. Got the 2-point lead right now. Everyone playing well, particularly Marvell Harris.
He's 25 points a game through the first two games, but look at this little yokey doke all the way to the basket over the long stretched arm of the defender.
Some of the most original uniforms in sports. Be sure to check them out over at tbtgear.com and treat yourself to some official TBT apparel. Great uniforms we've enjoyed out here in our Salt Lake City Regional. Team Challenge ALS, we've gotten used to seeing these over the last couple of years. Team with a cause on the other side, Everline Drive. The uniforms have evolved as this team has grown within the tournament. Not their first rodeo, Richie, but man, have they come a long way.
I agree with you. Both these teams continue to improve. Both these teams gunning for that $2 million prize in Chicago next week. And these uniforms continue to get better and better.
They do. You go back to the origins of Everline Drive. This used to be a neighborhood team, literally. That's what Everline Drive is. It's a neighborhood, and it was just a bunch of friends saying, hey, let's go out and play against some professional basketball players. What's the worst that could happen?
I'll tell you the worst that could happen. The GM, Jacob Hirschman, he got dunked on. The story is he got dunked on by Smush Parker that played for the Big Apple basketball team, but he'll change it and tell you, hey, look, that's just the legend. It was Luke Bonner, and there's the cul-de-sac in Everline Drive. I think they took off one of my tweets. That's the cul-de-sac. Everybody on Eberline Drive is tuned into us right now, Sam.
As they should be.
I don't know who the mascot is for Eberline Drive, but the Eberline Drive, fill in the blank, is playing pretty well right now in the regional championship game.
They went from, in the first 4 years, winning just one game total in the tournament, going to being one win away from a $2 million grand prize. They're hoping to close that gap here in 2019. One pass too many by DJ Strawberry, then he commits a foul in transition. And his team foul number four. So next foul on each side, it's going to be free throws.
Well, Jacob Hirschman said when he got dunked on, it was actually by Luke Bonner. He got dunked on so hard in that first year of the TBT by Smush Parker that he had to actually leave the game because he got bursitis in his elbow. He had to run to the hospital. And last year they were a 7 seed, not expected to be any good, but Jacob Hirschman, the other GM, Matt Mitchell, doing a great job of recruiting great players, getting together early, making practices happen. 7 seed goes all the way and loses the championship game.
Sean Marshall hits the three. Been a pretty good shooter in his TBT career. This tournament, it took him a little bit to get going. That's his first bucket of this contest. Makes it a 5-point lead. And there's an answer right back. Donald Sloan, after a slow first 2 days from deep, is heating up.
Two threes now for him, more than he's had in the whole tournament in the previous 2 games.
And a turnover forced by some pesky defense from Osiris Eldridge.
Head coach, Team Challenge ALS, Darren Collison, he told you, like you said a moment ago, he was worried about Donald Sloan getting off from behind the arc because he had struggled so bad the first 2 games.
One-on-one with Marshall.
He's got a handle, doesn't he?
Good defense there. Marshall sticking with it. Some help from Deshaun Stevens. Go down to the block. Stevens kicks it out. Bost open for three. Yes.
Talk about Deep Bost. His resume, he's won championships in Montenegro, Poland, France, in the NBA Summer League 4 times, training camp a pair of times. He's got a winning pedigree here with Team Challenge ALS.
Timeout taken by Eberline Drive. Let's listen and see what head coach David Nurse is talking about.
So what I'm saying with all this is, Marshall, we're not in this preferred stay up. Listen. Eyes gotta be right here. Now listen to you. Okay?
Don't start this shit.
Once you're coming off the screen, he's going to set you a high screen, okay, right at the slot, and then you got isolation with Marshall.
Let's go right now.
That is In the Huddle, presented by Puma Basketball. What's your takeaway from head coach Nurse?
Well, Donald Sloan is frustrated because he felt like he got fouled in that last play. He's talked to 2 different officials about it. So what Coach Nurse is going to do is going to get him the ball, and he's going to be a high ball screen at the top of the key, and they're looking for him to have some one-on-one isolation. So, you know, maybe he's done such a good job of working the refs that he gets a call here. Here's the isolation play. He can shake free, so he didn't shake free. So one-on-one now. There it is, to the basket. That's what he wanted, see? And he worked his way into that foul call. Talked to 2 different officials. Was upset about the previous play. They ran a play for him. Good call by Coach Nurse. And now he's going to get to the free throw line and be rewarded. The handle on Sloan. And look the way he goes right to Deshaun Stevens' chest. Deshaun Stevens, 6'8", probably has a wingspan close to 7 foot. Sloan is just 6'3", so what you do against a taller guy like that is you try to go into their chest, and sometimes that foul goes your way.
Substitutions, Orlando Johnson and Keith Benson will check back in, replacing Kanji and Ron. Johnson was the hot hand early for Eberline Drive. He had 8 points all in the first quarter. Sloan goes 1 for 2. Still a 2-possession lead for Team Challenge ALS. They got numbers coming back. Harris pulls up for 3, and Eberline Drive secures the rebound.
So now you have Randall back in the game. You got 2 elite guards right off the screen.
Randall, another 3.
telling you, been saying it all tournament. If Randall and Sloan can get hot at the same time, they are dangerous. They averaged about 43 points per game a year ago, and that projector put them all the way up into the TBT championship game, catapulted them that far.
Keith Benson commits the foul, and it is a bonus situation now, so free throws coming up for Team Challenge ALS. First foul on Benson. DeVos headed to the line.
Talk about him being a winner. He's not just a great scorer, but a great disher.
He's a winner here. That's a look at his winning share, which will be sent with Zelle. $138,461.54. I know we've talked about it throughout the tournament, but new day, new audience potentially. Everyone very, very, you know, democratic about giving out all the money evenly to everyone else. No one's saying, like, hey, I'm the star. I should get more money than that guy. Everyone's very even.
Because if they did, they wouldn't have a chance of winning. Who wants to play with that guy?
True.
You're angry at him the whole time.
All thrown into the scorer's table. A turnover back to Team Challenge ALS. It's never been a huge lead, never more than six, but it's been a very consistent lead for Team Challenge ALS. Day, way off on that three. Just under a 10-second shot clock, game clock differential. Everline drive, firing up a three. Yes, Osiris Eldridge.
Great kick out by Donald Sloan. He got all the way to the cup, realized his shot was going to be blocked, so he kicked it out to an open shooter.
All even at 35. And the timeout taken by Challenge ALS. They'll take their use it or lose it.
Well, you get three 30s in one full, but you have to use, like you said, one of those 30-second timeouts or you lose it for the second half. So that's good. So now they have 12 seconds to set up something to try to take a little bit of a lead before you go into the locker room.
FansOfTheTournament.com is your place for all things TBT. Follow your favorite team throughout the tournament. Be sure to check the schedule for week two of TBT regional competition as the tournament heads to Chicago for the championship rounds. That'll be on Thursday, and one of these two teams will be making their way to Chicago. Everline drives, several Chicago natives on the squad, hoping to go home, play in front of the hometown fans.
That'd be special. There's an extra feeling of comfort when you're in your hometown, right? Well, I would expect Team Challenge ALS to utilize a ball screen that, or maybe possibly go inside the post with Austin Day. Let him go to work. He's got Orlando Johnson guarding him right now. There's a mismatch size-wise, and Orlando Johnson is tough, physical, and strong. But look inside the post here, on the right side of your screen when we get there. Might be a ball screen by Austin Day in a pick and roll. Here it comes.
Boss hits the side of the backboard. Everline drive can do a half-court heave from Miller. And that is it for the first half. In a tournament that's seen three games of the six go to next point wins, it is fitting that we are tied at halftime in the regional final. Everline drive, 35. Team Challenge ALS, 35. We'll have intermission, come back, give you a big picture look at what's going on around the country in the basketball tournament. Even at 35 apiece at halftime in the final of our Salt Lake City region. Let's take a look around at what else is happening week two of the basketball tournament out in Wichita. Look at that spectacular crowds, but the hometown fans shocked as the aftershocks. The Wichita State alums lose to an original squad from TBT, sideline cancer.
We've already had one 8 seed win their region earlier in TBT play out in Memphis. How about a 6 seed at sideline cancer threatening to win the regional championship there?
Beat the Kansas alums, now the Wichita State alums, next up the Marquette alums, the Golden Eagles. Syracuse, that's the home bracket for Boeheim's Army. You know who those guys are, right? That's the Cuse alums.
Of course.
Team Brotherly Love on the other side. Bayheim's Army, a scare in round one, but a little smoother ride as they head into their regional final tomorrow on ESPN. Richmond, that's the home bracket for a little squad named Overseas League. You ever heard of them?
I've heard of them before. Oh, yeah. They've won $7 million together. They're a dynasty. They've won the last four TBTs. We'll see if they can go for five.
Average margin of victory, 20 points so far. They got to go through Team DRC to make it to Chicago. Speaking of which, here's a look at the four squads that have already written their names down for Championship Week. Winner of our game here tonight will take on Carmen's Crew out of Columbus region, the Ohio State alumni. You got Loyalty is Love, the DeMarcus Cousins coach team, and Jackson, Tennessee Underdogs. That's an understatement. The eighth seed making it all the way to the final eight of this tournament.
It's going to be a good one. Winner take all August 6th, $2 million.
Only one team will take it. Only one of our two teams tonight is going to have a chance to move on and play their way to that championship game. Tied at 35. Back with more in a moment here in Salt Lake. What a regional we've had here in Salt Lake City. Every game has been a nail biter, and it just so happens we got another one for the final. 35 apiece between Everline Drive and Challenge ALS. He's Richie Schuler. I'm Sam Farber. Richie, it's not only been close, it's been a little heated between these two teams. They've gotten familiar with each other over the years.
A little bit of chippiness. This is a budding rivalry. I mean, they played last year, last two teams to go to the TBT championship game. They both lost. They're both right there winning it. So I think they both have a good chance of getting $2 million in Chicago.
Taking a look at the highlights of this one. No one is really broken out for either side, but for Team Challenge ALS, there have been some moments for Deshaun Stevens.
Well, you know, he's been great, and so has Boss. D-Boss has been terrific. He had 10 points in the first half with a pair of threes as well. So D-Boss really helping Team Challenge ALS get it rolling. But for Everline Drive, it's been more of a community effort. Orlando Johnson, look at that dunk down the floor. He got going early. He had 8 points. I mean, he has been really good. Struggled yesterday from the field with the first game. Spell had a double-double. Look at this pass from Randall over to him. And Randall now getting buckets. Look at that move. A little inside and out and the pop and the shot. He hit two threes. That one from deep. And even Donald Sloan, he finally got out of a shooting slump, and he's doing fine just too. So these two teams really figuring it out offensively. We got a locked-in ball game here.
Look at the numbers. Everything is razor close. Team Challenge ALS, you'd expect them with their size advantage to do better on the glass. They're not winning in rebounds, but they are winning in second chance points.
Yeah, they are. Everline Drive is shooting the ball better, but because they have given up one more offensive board and they've turned the ball over a little bit, it's given Team Challenge ALS more opportunities to score. Thus, we have a tie game.
35 apiece. Last year, it was Everline Drive defeating Challenge ALS on their way to a runner-up finish. But of course, in the basketball tournament, runner-up is about the same as losing in round one. You get nothing for it other than the chance to compete on national television.
Yeah, I mean, it's winner take all. The stakes are high. The stakes are super high. Once you get to this point and you're playing in the regional championship, I mean, it's only been 2-3 days of basketball, but I mean, now they're starting to taste it. Both these teams realize they have a legitimate shot of getting to Chicago and getting back to that championship game. Once the August 1st hits and we're playing in the TBT Championship Week, those eight teams all feel like they can win the big game.
It's an interesting thought because, I mean, you get into it. We've talked ad nauseum about how much TBT has grown, even from last year where there were still a couple of those, you know, neighborhood teams who are just random dudes playing, maybe not any college or pro experience on them. Now everyone's got pros. Everyone is good. I wonder what point you really start to believe I could win $2 million. I could be a part of that team.
I think once you get to Chicago, it's like you're feeling it.
That's it.
And you're on national television. You're feeling good. You're giving it your all. And sometimes with the TBT, you'll see another player or two show up on some of these teams because they start to see that $2 million is for real.
You've seen how hotly contested every game has been. What it would be like if in the NBA, you know, the regular season said, you know, you only get paid if you win. We're going to pull all your money together. You all get your salaries you signed to, but you're only collecting if you win. Taylor Braun hits a three to open the scoring, and that's the first lead for Everline Drive in quite some time since the first quarter.
And Taylor Braun now with 8 points and 2 3-pointers to go with it. He's been playing tough, hard-nosed defense, knocking down shots on the offensive end.
Austin Day, turnaround jumper, perfect.
back to a one-point game. Now a good defensive stop. Sean Stevens getting the steal. Day from distance. Long rebound will be corralled by Jerome Randall. Kaji saw a charge coming and wisely got rid of the basketball. Sloan, 4-3, no. Kaji, tip, yes. 2 points. Haynes left alone. He'll hit the triple. Everybody's on fire to start the second half.
Now you can't sleep. Everline Drive just got beat down the floor. They made the bucket. They jogged back. Haynes sprinted back and got a clean look off.
Couple of players collide, and they're going to wipe up the floor here. There's no foul on the play. There have been some moments where the floor has had some saturation, mostly from guys hitting the deck.
Wet spot. I mean, that's just sweat dripping. You know what I mean? And you have people cleaning up sweat in between plays, but middle of the floor, you can't see all that. These guys are going hard. This isn't like your regular season NBA game in December. I mean, these guys are going at it. You know, both these guys, these group of guys, they don't necessarily love each other as a team as far as their opponent. They both feel like they should be dominating one another. Sweat's dripping out here, man.
Bodies hit the deck once again. Turnover. Challenge JLS, bring it the other way. Boss steps up. Rims out the three. Offensive rebound. For a moment, it will stay with Challenge JLS. Can you think about the other premier summer basketball experiences out there? Summer League comes to mind, but most of the players there, I'm not saying they don't play as hard, but most of the players there are young. They're right out of college or very recently out of college. Most of the guys here are pros. They've been playing professional basketball for 7-8 years, and you can see the intensity they bring.
Now, over 60 players in this year's tournament have NBA experience, and tons of them have played in Europe and South America and Asia in different places where basketball is good. That's a travel. There's only 23 players fresh out of playing Division I basketball who just finished their eligibility. Only 23 of them. There's also 23 alumni teams. You talked about all those alumni teams. Sideline cancer, huh?
You got to put together an alumni team for your squad.
For my college, my alumni. University of Evansville.
That's right.
The Purple Aces in Indiana.
Get some sweet jerseys out.
But when I played, we wore sleeves, yes. We wore sleeved uniforms.
See, now I think Puma would get in on that.
They probably would. Now,
call them up and say, hey, we want sleeved uniforms for TBT 2020.
Would they sell on the TBT website, sleeved uniforms? I mean, you know what, though? Like the Golden State Warriors had in the Miami Heat, they copied it off of Evansville. Didn't last long, but they copied it.
We're putting it down. We'd hate to lose you here at the desk, but, I mean, you get your chance at some uniforms, some sleeve uniforms for TBT 2020.
I've thought about coaching a team. Look at that. It's two good-looking guys right there. Oh, my gosh.
Now, the question is, would you get dunked on so hard by, who was it, Smush Parker, that you would be retired from TBT action?
Like Jacob Hirschman of Everline Drive. Nice and one. Oh, it's on the floor. Are they calling that and one, or are they calling it a foul?
It's on the floor.
Before the shot. I got it. Okay. Good call. Good call.
Third personal on DJ Strawberry. All even at 40. Just over 6 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. A reminder, we'll have the Elam ending to this one. First dead ball under 4 minutes of the fourth quarter. The clock goes dark. 8 added to whoever's in front. Or based off how the second half has gone, just 8 added. We've been tied the majority of the second half. And then it's first hit. The target score wins.
Did you expect anything less between these two teams? People kept asking, who do you think is going to win? I don't know.
Close is going to win.
I don't know. I mean, if Sloan and Randall can get on the same page offensively, and everybody's gunning for him now. Everybody's trying to stop him defensively because they were so good last year. But, man, if they both get off like they did last year, it's hard to beat them. But, man, Team Challenge ALS is so talented. And having Austin Day back a year ago, Austin Day, the big man, broke his jaw a week before the TBT. He didn't play. Now he's back, the big man. Now look at the little tug of the jersey.
Marquez Haynes hit with his third. That was ill-advised because you had Stevens diving on the deck. He was going to get the basketball either way. That's the fourth foul on Team Challenge ALS here in the third quarter. So next one will put Everline Drive at the line.
Everline Drive is goose egg. They haven't fouled yet. Everline Drive can get a little distance here if they can continue to get fouled at the free throw line.
Offensive board and the putback. Keith Benson.
A double-double last night. 5 of 9 from the field. 10 boards, 11 points.
CBT rookie puts Everline Drive up by 2. Chris going down low, trying to find Stevens, taken away. In transition, Miller funnels the pass. They blow the whistle, a foul on the way up the floor.
That's good. Get down. You always can get smaller perimeter players to get steals on post players when they're trying to post up. Just get your hands in there. You're lower to the ground. Once they dribble, you can usually get a piece of it, steal it, deflect it. Good defense.
That is the fifth foul, so Pat Miller to the line. 27-year-old from Chicago, Illinois.
This is scary for Team Challenge ALS. We have 5 minutes of bonus free throws in 2 every time. If I'm Everline Drive, and I'm David Nurse, I'm putting the pressure on Team Challenge ALS. I'm doing everything I can to set screens, handoffs, and drive the ball and take my chances of getting fouled inside the paint or on the way to the paint. It gives you 2 free throws for the next 5 minutes and 11 seconds.
Austin Day will take a breather. Marcus Haynes back in the game. Pat Miller hits them both. 4-point lead for Everline Drive. That's their largest of the contest. They're going to go to a 2-3 zone here.
I like it. Switch it up, change it up. Now he's got to be able to rebound in it. Got to find somebody to block out. Look what it's done.
Forces the steal. Miller can't track it down.
But they forced the turnover. The 2-3 zone took Team Challenge ALS by surprise. You need some help inbounding it.
44-40. It's round 3 contest, our finale here in Salt Lake City. Winner will move on to Chicago and be one of the final 8 teams competing for the $2 million winner-take-all prize. DeBoss checking back in. He had all 10 of his points in the first half. It's been a slow start to the second for Team Challenge ALS shooting the basketball. Haynes, an open look. Got it.
Let's see if Everline Drive does that. Let's see if they look to penetrate more and pick up some fouls. 2 free throws on every foul the rest of the quarter. That's a foul. Oh, offensive on Brown.
Going to be on the screener, Keith Benson. Second personal.
He moved on the screen. Got to stay stationary. Feet got to be about shoulder width apart. Can't move your hips. Can't move your feet.
Not sure why we have the stoppage there. We'll get back underway. 2-point ball game. We'll pass the halfway mark of this third quarter. Sam Farber, Richie Schuler here with you in Salt Lake City. Marvell Harris. Missing the 3. Good box out by Taylor Braun.
That's a foul on him. Should be. I think that's a foul on Boss on the blockout.
Yeah. That means Taylor Braun's heading to the line. He's going to shoot some free throws when we come back to Salt Lake. 2-point game. Winner goes to Chicago. $2 million, the winner-take-all prize in TBT 2019. Here's a look at how Everline Drive will share their $2 million sent with Zell. See, now they did spread the money out a little bit. You've got the GMs, head coach, $110,000 each. Each player gets $142,500. They've got a sponsor, a booster collecting a share. James Michael McAdoo might come later in the tournament, so he plays less games. That's why he gets less money.
Minor injury, and so he's not here. They get to Chicago, though. James Michael McAdoo is going to be a huge addition for this Everline Drive team. Now, here's some players they had last year, though. Willie Reed, but he chose to play for Loyalty as Love. Boogie's team, DeMarcus Cousins. Jeremy Evans they had on this team a year ago that lost in the championship game of the TBT. Evans signed a deal with a team in Russia. They also had Christian Watford and one or two other players as well.
Lou Amundsen, the 10-year NBA vet, was on the squad. So there have been some changes. The core of both these teams is the same as last year for Challenge JLS. We're talking about, of course, Sean Marshall, some of his guys he's brought back, Austin Day, Everline Drive, Jerome Randall, Donald Sloan. But both teams, you know, whether it's an alumni squad or a local GM, they make the moves. Taylor Braun goes 2 for 2. He's into double figures, and the lead is back to 4 for Everline Drive.
It's interesting. Everline Drive has taken 3 less field goals, yet they're shooting 50%, which is terrific. They even have 3 more turnovers. They've turned the ball over more, yet they have a 4-point lead because they're shooting the ball so well. They're also getting to the free throw line.
Especially impressive considering how good defensively Team Challenge ALS is. Drive by Miller, a lot of contact, no call, doesn't matter. Lay-in is there. Osiris Eldridge, his first bucket of the second half.
If you're a defensive team and the offense gets to the middle of the floor like that, like Miller just did, bad things are going to happen. And that's why that play was able to take place. Broke down the defense, and he had a cutter to the rim.
Marvell Harris, quiet evening for him, averaging 25 a game in the tournament. He's been held to 5 today. Marshall, well short on the 3. Rebound, last touch by Challenge ALS.
This is interesting. Now look at this. See, he goes middle. He draws the defense in. And then his teammates cutting from the corner into the paint. Great basketball, great read by Osiris Eldridge.
They've reversed the call. It's going to be Challenge ALS basketball.
When these two teams played last year, Team Challenge ALS in the first half was shooting like 27%. Now they've been shooting considerably better in this game. In the halftime this game, they're like 43%. They're still hovering right around there. And they just got down early. This is a neck-and-neck game, much different than a year ago.
Offensive rebound for Stevens, who'll earn himself a trip to the line. Mentioned it earlier, but Team Challenge ALS, they don't wear their own names on their backs. They wear the names of someone they know who is battling ALS. And for Deshaun Stevens, it goes back to his college time at San Diego State. And legendary coach Steve Fisher's son has been a part of that staff. And Deshaun Stevens obviously has a close relationship with him.
Yeah, Mark Fisher, he's assistant to the head coach, now working with Brian Dutcher. But he's been battling ALS for 6 years. He's always in thoughts and prayers. And he's such a nice guy, such a friendly guy before the disease, and even with the disease, he hasn't changed.
It's an important part of why this team is here. A crew with a cause, seeing Sideline Cancer make their way into their regional championship. They're going to take on the Marquette alums tomorrow out in Wichita. Good passing by Everline Drive, but Osiris Eldridge can't make it count in the end. A rebound to DeBoss. Haynes in the lane, kicks it out. Harris.
Oh, nice move.
Nice pass.
Say, Harris finds ways to win, doesn't he? He's been huge the last two games, averaging about 25 a game. And that little move to the paint and dump off, beautiful basketball. He's a winner.
Randall yet to score in the second half. Splits two defenders, kicks it out. Braun open for 3. short. Good look down low, Marshall. And one opportunity.
Everline drive not really capitalizing on the fact that they were in double bonus. 5 minutes to go in the quarter. Team Challenge LS just fighting right back. Sean Marshall, the GM, the player. The most recognized name here for Team Challenge LS. Great career at Boston College. Didn't play professionally this past season, but he spent 11 years overseas in the D-League in Greece, France, Germany, Turkey. Now in his fifth year of the TBT.
Completes the three-point play, and we're all tied up at 48. Eldridge can't hit the three. Another rebound for Challenge ALS, but Eldridge sneaks in to steal it away. And it's ping-ponging back and forth. There's a two-handed slam. Once he got his hands on it, Benson knows what to do with it.
1 minute away to the fourth quarter. Elamending coming up soon. Midway through the fourth.
And the final minute of the third quarter right here. Marshall misses the jumper. Lead is two for Everline Drive. Sloan finds Randall in the corner. Yes. It's interesting, Richie. As well as Everline Drive has played as much as they've led this third quarter, that's the first point in the second half for either Randall or Sloan.
How about that? And now a trio of three-pointers for Randall.
He's the closer. Watch for him in the fourth. Good cut by Marshall.
Should be the last possession.
Randall's going to hold for the last shot. He'll let it fly. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. Everline Drive with a three-point advantage, 53-50. Jerome Randall, the Chicago native. Oh, baby, don't you want to go to Sweet Home Chicago? They're one quarter away. TBT 2019, the $2 million winner-take-all basketball tournament is presented by Puma Basketball. See on that TBT basketball, Elam ending. All games must end on a made basket. That is the calling card of this tournament. You cannot run out the clock. You have to make a shot. That's what will happen here at the end of the fourth quarter. We've talked about it a lot, but I really think, you know, it was starting to get sprinkled out there. Is this the future of the NBA or college? I really think high school AAU basketball, this would be the perfect addition.
Even if it never does, what I think is cool about it is it's unique to the TBT. And it's made the last 4 minutes of games be for a 13-minute game in college basketball, the last 4 minutes, it's only 6.5 for TBT. It cuts it in half. It makes the offenses play a little more assertively. You can't just play the stall game. And man, everybody wins on a winning shot. Less than 20% of the time is it a free throw. It's usually a three-pointer, dunk, or a layup.
Good lob to Dime. Blocked by David. A foul is called. You can't believe it. Personal on him.
Yeah, I don't think they thought he got a clean block off.
Nope, Malik Dime's going to head to the line. Scoreless so far today. 26-year-old out of the University of Washington. Malik Dime's winning share will be sent with Zell. $142,500. Coming his way if Everline Drive can win one more game than they won last year, Richie. They were the runners-up to Overseas Elite in 2018.
And if Team Challenge ALS gets there, they're going to look different. Deshaun Stevens was injured in that championship game 2 years ago. It felt like they could have won it had he not been hurt. And with a healthy Austin Day on the roster, broken jaw last year, I mean, either one of these teams that get through the regional, can make a really strong run at that $2 million bucks August 6th.
Marvell Harris hit one earlier here in the fourth quarter. Comes up short that time. So 1 point lead for Everline Drive. Corner three on the way. And not close. Harris into traffic. A jump ball.
Great defense by Randall. Wow. He went straight up, got his hand tied in with the basketball. Look at this. Is this a foul or just look at Randall's defense. Goes straight up and touch the ball. No body contact. That's incredible defense by the little guy, 5'10", Jerome Randall. Unbelievable. And that's why he's so well respected by his teammates as a leader.
Been calling him the closer. He had the winning shot in each of Everline Drive's first two games here, both of which came down to next point wins. And he had the shot to eliminate Challenge ALS a season ago. Steal by Marshall, and he's hung up by Orlando Johnson in transition. First team foul of the fourth quarter.
Marshall looking to get a piece of that basketball. That's terrific. That's terrific. So we're seeing really good defense on both ends. Both using their feet to be in place to make the play, and then using their hands to tie up or steal a basketball.
Harris going up against a shot blocker time. I don't think so.
Kind of reminds me. Look at this defense right here. Unbelievable. You know what this reminds me of, Sam? Me playing Papa Shot against you last night. I beat you six times.
They're still talking right now. And now both are getting teed up.
That is not what you need in the fourth quarter of the regional championship. We talked about it early. The officials even told us. It's a great block shot. Malik Dime followed up with a stare down of Marvell Harris. He didn't appreciate that. Harris won't stop talking. It's unnecessary. You got your shot block. It's over. Move forward. Not that big of a deal. You got the ball right back. Did we see technical fouls?
One for Dime, one for Harris. For Harris, that is his third personal as well. Marshall trying to go down low, and Day couldn't handle it. Sloan to Randall. Hung up and turns it over. Marvell Harris with a two-on-one. He's going to try and do it himself. What a block by Pat Miller.
There's still some more jawing. Dime looked back at Marvell Harris, and the jawing continued.
Three for Sloan. What a sequence.
Defense turns into offense, and that's why you got Malik Dime, the fourth best shot blocker. There he is guarding the ball in Washington history, and he only played 2 years there. What a rim protector.
It was 54-53 at the time as Day puts it in. If Harris makes the bucket, they take the lead. Instead, they go down four at the moment because a three went down on the other side. How about that?
It's good to see Sloan. Yeah, I mean, Sloan getting out of that shooting slump he was in the first two games. Look at Malik Dime. What? I'm not even sure that was Dime. That might have been Pat Miller that got that block, and then he pushed up the floor for the three-point play. Dime was there. Miller got the block. Unbelievable. And that's Miller hustling back on defense. That's why you don't give up on transition. Don't just assume the team's going to get an easy layup. Run back on defense. There was two back there. Block shot, three-pointer on the other end. That could prove to be the play of the game if Everline Drive ends up pulling away.
Now Miller and Harris continue to talk to one another as we wait for the inbound. They're checking the table. That was the fourth foul on Marvell Harris. On his sixth, he'll be eliminated. He has been a premier player in this tournament, 25 points per game. Three on the way from Randall. Got it!
A broken play ends up as a three-point shot for Randall. And we are just under 2 minutes away from potentially Elam ending time.
Answer on the other end, D-Boss.
It's been terrific. D-Boss, the big-time scorer for Team Challenge ALS. He is really shaken free. Didn't score more than 8 points in this tournament this year until tonight.
Cyrus Eldridge flying in for the rebound. Randall missed the three, and Austin Day pulls down the board and is fouled. Two-point game right now. We're about 90 seconds of clock away from being in Elam-ending territory. In terms of pace of play, this is still very much a Team Challenge ALS style of game. Lower scoring, more highly contested defensively. Not saying Everline Drive can't play this way, but this is the kind of style Challenge ALS would prefer.
Everline Drive's got a two-point lead, so clearly they're playing it well. But you're right, the pace of play probably favors ALS. Almost an illegal screen there.
The deflection leads to a turnover. Killer crossover from Randall into the defense, missed the lay-in. Marshall, one-on-one opportunity. He'll fire up a three. Rims out. It's halfway down. That would have given them the lead. It's been intense all the way through, and it's only going to get more so as we get into the Elam ending. Benson. Blocked. No, a foul call.
I thought there was a foul and some contact potentially by Austin Day. They let it go. And then when the shot went up, then it appeared they called the foul on the shot rather than on the dribble. Check it out. Look at right here. So he's got his shorts. That's a foul right there. He fouled him on the floor before the shot. That's why Austin Day's frustrated, because it looked like it was a clean block. Austin Day was guilty of a foul before the shot. I think maybe that foul should have been called earlier to prevent the interaction in and of itself.
To the line goes Keith Benson out of Oakland, native of Dallas, Texas, a TBT rookie. Missed the first.
Going to end up coming down to that Elam ending, that target score, and how do they play it? And both these teams have played very well in that stretch of time. Both these teams have made it far. The Elam ending is nothing new to either one of these squads. They don't tighten up when the clock turns off. They continue playing their game.
Day going to work. One-on-one with Benson. Fades away. Well defended by Benson. But the rebound, last touch by Everline Drive. This is big here. If Challenge ALS can get a bucket and tie things up once we get into Elam ending territory, that could be very significant, establishing that final number. Instead, they turn it over. And now if you're Everline Drive, Richie, do you just hold and wait till you're under the four-minute mark and call the timeout?
You know, everybody has a different strategy, and I think that's what David Nurse is saying right now. Go ahead and burn a timeout. Stop the clock. There it is.
Call the timeout. So, Elam ending goes into effect. It has been an absolute dogfight here in Salt Lake City. 68 is the target score. Who will advance? The 2018 runners-up or the 2017 runners-up? We'll find out when we come back to Salt Lake City. Here it is, maybe the future of basketball, the present of TBT, the Elam ending. First dead ball under 4 minutes. Turn off the clock. You do not need it. Just add 8 to the leading team score, and that is your target score. First team to reach the number wins it. And what a competition we've had here in Salt Lake City. 3 times in our first 6 games, Richie, we had next point win situations. In all but one of our games, we've had it where either side was a bucket away from winning the game.
Some of the best games in the TBT this year, and this is by far the best TBT in history in the 6 years. So much talent, so many great teams, so many alumni squads, so many former NBA players. This is big time, and this is my favorite part of the game, the Elam ending.
Cyrus Eldridge steps back, missed the three.
That looked good. That looked pretty.
Good Harris down low. Works it back outside. He'll head fake the three. Fires and hits.
Walking bucket, Marvell Harris.
Team challenge ALS now with the advantage, and they're 7 points from closing it out. Sloan, a little hesitation move. Can't get it to go. An offensive rebound.
Trying to get in the big fella.
Benson, one-on-one with Stevens, and offensive foul.
How about that? Working hard, trying to get positioning. See what he does here to extend his arm. A lot of contact down there. It's been like that. It's been chippy all game. Yeah, he put his left elbow right into his defender. It's an easy call for the official.
Fifth personal on Benson. Something to keep an eye on as well. Next one, he'd be out. 6-0 run right now for Team Challenge ALS.
A lot of chippiness, a lot of talking, a lot of competitive nature. These players have a lot of respect for each other, but man, this is a rivalry. Nice shot fake, Harris.
Line drive, comes away with it. Randall, call him the closer. He scored every one of Everline Drive's points during the Elam ending yesterday.
Two game winners.
On the tournament. That's absolutely true. Hit it against Team Challenge ALS last year as well. Comes up short that time. Advantage still held by Challenge ALS. Great move. Harris lays it in.
It's been alive. 13 points now.
Timeout, Everline Drive. Well, the Elam ending, I think we can agree, is our favorite thing about TBT. Second favorite is the inside the huddle access that we get. So let's go inside the huddle, presented by Puma Basketball with Everline Drive and head coach David Nurse. By three right now. Still 8 points away from the Elam ending, and now here comes Coach Nurse. Let's listen in.
There we go. Get a shot here. Two looks. Two really good looks. Look here. Slow. Hey, you're gonna go. Go with screen down. Screen down. Screen down. Come out. First Sloan, come out. Three, come out. Hit here. Sorry, hit four. Hit three. Hit three right here. Hit three right here.
It's a box set, starts with down screens, but at the end of the day, what you're trying to do is you're trying to get your shooter under the basket, and then imagine elevator doors closing. The two players at the elbow, the guy that's under the basket is going to come swinging through the free throw line, and the elevator doors are going to shut. It's going to be like a double screen. They should have a three at the top of the key. That's what they're looking to get here. So it's a box set right here, two down screens. There you go. Now Sloan's going to go under the basket. And now they got a broken play because of great defense. So now they just got to play ball, run their motion. It ends up with Sloan and ball in his hands, and that's his shot.
Well, Everline Drive had it all drawn up. Challenge ALS just too good defensively. It's been their calling card here at Salt Lake City. They are five away from closing it out. Elam ending target score is 68. Challenge ALS is on an 8-0 run right now. Harris drops it off. Nice finish by Stevens.
All three scores in the elimination time as a result of Marvell Harris. He made two buckets and now an assist.
And now they are 3 points away. This is where we've seen teams start to get a little too in love with what they need to end it and not with what the best shot is. But they got to play good defense right now. Sloan drives, and it's a charge. Well taken, Marvell Harris again.
Critical calls at critical times. Neverline drive, maybe forcing things a little bit too much. Are they in position? It's a pretty good call. I thought Sloan was airbound, and a great job. Is that Marvell Harris that took the charge? The same one that's been getting buckets and assists here in the Elam bending. I mean, he's a player. He is a player.
They are 3 points away. Do you take one here, Richie?
If it's open, you don't force a three. You get a layup, you're up by seven. It's a three-possession game.
Lob. It was a little too tall, even for Deshaun Stevens, but recovered by Challenge ALS. This is for the win. Air ball. Stevens got it. Out to Bost. He can end it. Another offensive board for Challenge ALS.
Okay. They didn't make the shots. Don't need that three-point shot. Of course, it'll win. They'll put the exclamation point on it, but you have 30 seconds.
They're going to take a look at this one on the monitor. The original call, I believe, was to keep it with Challenge ALS. But they'll take a closer look.
Well, you tell me what you think. It's off of White. It's off White. Great hustle by Eldridge, but it's off him. That should be Team Challenge ALS ball with 30 seconds in the shot clock.
Great job by our crew, by the way. Thanks to everyone here in Salt Lake City for all their help, led by our producer, Josh Weber. It's been an outstanding 3 days of basketball, lots of excitement. And we couldn't bring it all to you without our outstanding crew.
They're going to keep reviewing that. I would be surprised if they didn't give it to Team Challenge ALS. It's the original call on the floor, too, right?
That's how they had it. And it will stay Challenge ALS basketball. I would presume Darren Collison was going over it. What he wanted to do here, they have confirmed the call. Here's the head coach, just retired from a 10-year NBA career. We even asked him, hey, is there any chance you might play this year?
Yeah.
He was pretty coy about it. Maybe.
He said maybe, but I'm like 40. He's like, no, I'm not playing. I'm good.
He said there's been more teams calling him than necessarily his agent or him reaching out to them.
And if the right opportunity comes, but I respect his decision. I want to hang out with his family some more.
Do a lot more charity work as well. Here's a three for the win. Harris, halfway down. Neverline drive still alive.
One possession there. That one possession, Team Challenge ALS took three threes. I thought one of them might have been forced, but two of them looked clean.
Randall tripped up, and that will put him at the line as we're in the bonus.
If you're Neverline drive, when you go back on the defensive end of the floor, you just have to take away the three-pointer. Neverline drive has a rim protector in the back in Keith Benson. So you have some length back there to take away in case they tried to drive, but you might consider switching on the perimeter to take away three-point shots. Because if you're going under ball screens, you're doing that kind of thing, oftentimes you're going to get a clean look at a three-point shot. You'd rather them go to inside the paint and go inside your rim protector. So a couple of really good defensive possessions, and if Everline Drive continues to score here in the offensive end, got a chance to crawl right back in here.
That ends a 10-0 run for Challenge ALS. That free throw, Randall hits them both. So they are now 6 points away from the target score. Challenge ALS is three away. And the timeout's going to be taken by Challenge ALS. Now, if you're using a timeout, is that a sign that you're drawing up a three?
I would almost use a timeout to tell them you don't need a three. Darren Collison says. It's been a lot of these matchups.
Time to go in the huddle presented by Puma Basketball.
Quite pick up what he was trying to say there. I know I heard Darren Collison saying at one point, hey, let's run that play that we used to run. So clearly, with a little bit of practice time that they've had and whatnot, they've got some experience with each other and some familiarity in situations like this.
A three would win it for Challenge ALS. Boss down low to Stevens. Double team, turnover forced by Braun. And now Everline drive could tie with a three.
Need a three, but certainly take it. They get a good look.
Randall works his way inside. Well defended by Deshaun Stevens.
Got a fast break. Just go for a two. You don't need to pull up for a three. I like this by Marvell Harris. Drive inside there. Good kick. Now a great shot.
For the win. Still won't go down, and Stevens will just take two. Fell right in his lap. Challenge ALS is 1 point away. Everline Drive will use a timeout. Well, they kept firing from three. Eventually, yeah. Stevens had no choice but to dunk it.
Well, look at this, though. Marvell Harris does a good job. He's looking to penetrate. But once he's cut off, he does a great job of kicking it. And then the terrific extra pass. And just ends up on the 50-50 ball to Deshaun Stevens. And he puts the exclamation point on it. They're a point away. They're in the bonus as well, so if they get fouled, they get two free throws to try to win it. All pressure is on Everline Drive. And if I'm them, I'm switching everything on the perimeter to try to spook Team Challenge ALS and maybe get a steal going the other way for an easy bucket.
Everline Drive needs six for the Elam ending. And next point for Challenge ALS will close it out. They want to go to Chicago. It's a team with championship game experience. Sean Marshall. Back in 2017, averaged 18 points per game. He's had a decidedly different role in this tournament. But even with that being said, they've got some of that championship pedigree. You look back, Austin Day was a part of that team that finished as a runner-up. Marvell Harris was. The core of this team knows what it's like to play for $2 million. First Everline Drive, a chance to cut in. Sloan for three. Braun gets the board. A three-pointer here for Everline Drive changes the whole dynamic of this game.
Yeah.
Another stop. Next point wins it. Boss. Way short. Now a run out. Sloan will take it in and lay it in.
Uh-oh. Two-possession game for Everline Drive. Team Challenge ALS tried to get fouled on offense. Put the pressure on the defense by penetrating the basketball. Get to the free throw line and win it that way.
Strawberry. It outside. Marvell Harris. Shot clock is still in effect. It's at six. Harris. Odd angle. No. Stevens the rebound. Kicks it out. Boss trying to throw it down low. It's taken away. Here comes Everline Drive. Extra pass to Randall. Floats it in.
It's a one possession game. Oh my goodness. We got a ball game here. This is a lot of fun. Look at the unselfishness basketball And then Randall with the beautiful floater in the paint. Oh my goodness.
Team Challenge ALS will have yet another possession to try and win it. They've had several shots. The pressure has been building and building as Everline Drive is cut in. And now, if Challenge ALS doesn't score on this possession for the first time, Everline Drive will have a shot to win it. Let's go inside the huddle.
To see the way Collison talks to the players. He's coming off a 10-year NBA career, and Marvell Harris is asking good questions. In this case, we do this, but if we don't do that and we do this, and he's got that calm demeanor about him. Both these coaches are really good with their players, and I think it instills confidence in them. No foul can happen, because if a foul happens, whatever team has two free throws, you have to play solid defense without fouling and don't give up any layups. Now you want to keep the ball outside the three and force contested outside shots.
We're ready to go. Marquez Haynes will bring it up. Next point for Challenge ALS wins it. A bucket for Everline Drive would end it. Harris into the lane. Harris, well defended. And here comes Everline Drive. Their first chance to end the game. And they're going to the closer. Jerome Randall, he has won each of their first two here in Salt Lake City. Pulls up for the win. Little shorts, offensive board though. To the cutter, Braun, got it! Everline Drive is going to Chicago!
That's an incredible comeback. They beat Team Challenge ALS last year in the quarterfinals and advanced all the way to the championship game. And now here in the regional championship to get to the quarterfinals, they do it again.
Everline Drive was in a situation where any points for Challenge ALS would have ended possession after possession, and they go on a 6-0 run. Broken play, loose ball, collected, Eldridge to a cutting run, and he lays it in. And Everline Drive is going to Chicago. Osiris Eldridge, Jerome Randall, Pat Miller, they're all Chicago natives, so they're going home to play for $2 million. You have got to love TBT. Head coach David Nurse with his team as they put it on Everline Drive. Second straight year they have defeated Challenge ALS, and they are going to Chicago trying to get back to that championship game and trying to this time come away with the $2 million grand prize. What a finish. Let's go to Richie Schuler. He's standing by with head coach David Nurse and the closer, Jerome Randall.
We're sitting right here with Jerome. How you doing, man? How about that comeback?
I'm exhausted. team showed a lot of heart tonight. They was doing a lot of talking. We just let the game come to us.
So I'm talking about Jerome Randall. You had two game winners throughout the course of this. You guys had two games where it was next point win. Here you had to have 2 points. What is it about the Elam ending time that you start performing at your best?
I think guys are worried too much about hitting a home run shot when you should just play basketball like it's 4 minutes left on in the game. And I think people are trying to do too much and make the hero shots, and we're just trying to play and win. And it's happening. It's working for us.
Well, tell me this. You're from Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
Two of your teammates are from Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
Now you guys are going to Chicago. Does that help your chances in your mind?
It's just good to be home. I know the whole Chicago coming out to support us, and that's all we care about right now.
That's what I'm talking about. Congratulations. Let me get over here to Coach Nurse. Coach, how you feeling, man?
Unbelievable. First of all, I got to say thank you to the Lord for that win, for the win before that, for the win before that. He wants to make us earn it, and he's definitely making us earn it.
What is it about the Elam ending for you as a coach? You guys have made it interesting, right? We've talked about that. This one, you guys were down big in the Elam ending. It didn't look good, but your demeanor in the timeouts is outstanding. You guys keep it really calm and cool, and I think it affects your players. What do you do to make your players play so well at that time?
Well, first of all, it's all the players that do it, but I have to, sure, my heart's beating a million miles an hour, but I have to play it like I'm very calm and collective and very confident. I'm very confident in our players for sure, but if they see confidence in me, it's going to exude confidence in them. And man, we got the most heart I've seen of any team to play those three games like that, be down 6-5, 6-7, and to still stick with it and come back. It's a lot to be said for that. Make a movie of this. When we win this thing, make a movie of this.
And I know that rematch felt great to win again. Is there something about that Nurse last name, though? Since your uncle just won the NBA championship, are you guys going to win the TBT championship?
I say we are. I think it's good mojo going for us. But no, I've learned a lot from my uncle. He showed me the way. He's taught me a lot along the way. So if I could be 10% as good as coach as he is, then we're doing something.
Congratulations, man. Make it happen in Chicago. All right, take care.
Nick Nurse won a title with the Raptors, and now David Nurse's Everline Drive Squad is one step closer to winning the $2 million winner-take-all TBT. There it is. Everline Drive will take on the Ohio State Alumni Squad, Carmen's Crew, out in Chicago, a homecoming for Jerome Randall, the closer, and some of his fellow guards, Osiris Eldridge and Pat Miller. It's going to be a lot of fun. Still three more spots to determine tomorrow, so make sure you're locked in for all the great TBT action across the country as we pencil in those last three spots in the final eight in Chicago. That's going to do it for us here in Salt Lake City. For Richie Schuler and our entire crew, I'm Sam Farber saying it's been a pleasure and a privilege having you with us. Great run by Team Challenge ALS, but Everline Drive, let's drive to Chicago.